Good morning students. Now we will see the continuity of human reproduction lesson. So human reproduction lesson, we see the male reproductive organ, female reproductive organ, all the things. Now we are go to see the next 2.4, menstrual disorder. Before that menstrual disorder, first we know that what is menstrual cycle or menstruation. The menstrual or ovarian cycle occur approximately once in every 20 to 29 days during the reproductive life of a female. It is otherwise menorrha to menopause, except during pregnancy the menstrual cycle is taking place in a female reproductive body. So in this menstrual cycle, some disorders are happen. That is that due to some difficult conditions, some disorders are happen in a female menstrual cycle. So these, what are the disorders? Now we are seeing in this lesson. So menstrual disorder means absence of menstruation. It is called as amenorrhagia. So if a menorrhagia does not, that means menorrhagia means puberty. If a puberty or menorrhagia does not appear till the age of 18, it is called primary menorrhagia. It is not a big problem. The absence of menstruation for over 3 consecutive months, it is called as a secondary amenorrhagia. So polymenorrhagia means it is used describe menstrual cycle. It is shorter than 21 days. Normal menstrual cycle is 28 to 29 days, but it is 21 days. It's shorter than the 21 days. That type of a disorder, it is called as a polymenorrhagia. Why it's happen means the frequent ovulation is produced by our pituitary gland. So hyperactivity occur in our pituitary gland. So it is ovulation is happen frequently. So that disturb physiological and malnutrition of the body, so it causing polymenorrhagia. So in other, sometimes polymenorrhagia is happen due to the sexual transmitted disease, STD, we are called as a STD, sexually transmitted disease, such as chlamydia or gonorrhea. It is also cause polymenorrhagia. So polymenorrhagia is caused many reasons. So what is polymenorrhagia means? The life menstrual cycle is reduced in 120 days. So dysmenorrhagia, it is pain associated with menstruation is called. So if menstrual time the pain will be occur, it is called as a dysmenorrhagia. So it's most commonly reproductive menstrual disorder. There are two types of dysmenorrhea, primary dysmenorrhea and secondary. So primary means pain or cramp during the menstrual period. It is secretion of prostaglandin, so in the uterus. So secondary menorrhagia is disorder reproductive system like endometrium, uterine fibroidity. So heavy or prolonged menstrual period, the disturbed woman's normal body, a normal activity, referred to as a menorrhagia. So this is caused due to hormonal imbalance, ovarian dysfunction, uterine fibroid, so many reasons. The cancer in cancer of ovary and uterus or cervix, so these are called as a menorrhagia. Then oligomenorrhagia is a condition, infrequent menstrual period. So that is a woman who regularly goes more than 35 days without menstruating may are diagnostic with oligomenorrhagia. So these are the menstrual disorder we seen in a disorder seen in a female. Next we go to menstrual hygiene. So menstrual hygiene is a vital for good health, well-being, dignity, empowerment and productivity of the human. So menstrual hygiene is very, very important for all the human. So this can keep a girl inactive during such a period, leading a abstinence from school. So the hygiene is, you never doing any hygienic in a menstrual time, so it causing many problem in our
life cycle. So clean and safe, so how you can hygiene, so keep a clean and safe absorbable clothing material or sanitizing napkins or pads or some menstrual cups are also in a now in a economical condition. So you use any one, but all the things are keep a clean and safe and hygienic in condition. So the another one point, changing a sanitary material, any one of sanitary material, 4 to 5 hours as per the requirement, and provides a comfort, cleanliness and productive for the infection. So the used sanitary napkin should be wrapped in, used in the sanitary napkin you never throw outer, you can covered the napkins, wrapped the napkin with a paper and throw in a proper area. So don't throw in a drainage pipes or toilets or flushed flushing areas, that will be soak and damage, soak the drainage and leads to water pollution. So next we go to menopause. Menopause means is a phase in a woman's life when a ovulation and menstruation stop, that is called as a menopause. Menstrual cycle will be stopped, that is called as a menopause. So when the menopause is happen in the age of 45 to 50 years, the average age of 45 to 50 years, the menopause will be happen. So it indicate permanent cessation of the primary function of the ovary. So after menopause, the ovary is not produced. So this is called as a menopause. Next we go to fertilization and implementation. So what is fertilization and implementation? Simply, fertilization, you know that two haploid cells are combined to form a diploid cell. So male and female haploid cells, male cell is sperm, female cell is ovary, ovum, egg. So these two combine to form a zygote, diploid zygote. It is called as a fertilization. So the sperm deposit in a female reproductive tract undergo capsation, which is a biochemical event that enable the sperm penetrate the fertilized the egg. So fertilization occur only if the ovum and sperm are transported simultaneously to ampulla isthmus junction of the fallopian tube. You know that the structure of a structure of the human female reproductive organ. This is the structure of the female. So this is a this is a ovary. So in this ovary, the egg will be produced. So that egg move to the oviduct. Oviduct have 3 parts. Already you know that oviduct have a 3 parts. So in the 3 parts, when the egg meet at the isthmus junction of a fallopian duct, so that time the sperm will be meet at this region. So meet at in the isthmus region only, that egg will be undergo fertilization, producing a young bird. If the egg will be move other part of that female reproductive organ, that is it's moved to the ovum, that means ovum or in a uterus region, automatically that will be undergo menstrual cycle. So when the sperm enter or reached this region, that is isthmus region, that region only the fertilization is taking place. So how the fertilization is taking place, already know that the structure of the structure of the male reproductive cell, that sperm. The sperm, the 3 regions are there: head, neck and tail region. So head region, it having one acrosome is there, one nucleus above acrosome is there. So what is the function of the acrosome? It producing one enzyme that is called iodinase. This enzyme breaking a egg outer membrane, that is zona pellucida region. You see this picture. So first step, the egg that sperm will be enter into the zona pellucida region. Zona pellucida, when it touched, automatically the acrosome will be released. Acrosome will be released one enzyme that is called as the hyaluronidase enzyme. So this enzyme penetrate, destroy the zona pellucida wall. So after that, the egg membrane wall, it's entering a egg membrane wall. So this, when it touched that, once the fertilization of accumulated cortical granules from cytoplasm, the ovum form a barrier called fertilization membrane. So when it is entered the zona pellucida region, after it's entered to the egg membrane, after that the sperm nucleus will be released. You see here the sperm nucleus will be released. So it's entered, so it form automatically when the nucleus enter into cytoplasm, the egg will be form a cortical granules. So this cortical granules creating a membrane that is called as a fertilization membrane. Why it create a fertilization membrane? Because so many millions of sperms are enter that in isthmus wall in one time of ejection. So only one sperm will be connected to the egg, other sperm will not able to connect to the egg. So that will be stopped with the help of a cortical granules. So when it's entered, it prevent this cortical granules prevent penetration of the sperm, thus polysperm is preventing. So next, the first what happened, the sperm nucleus will be entered into the cytoplasm, egg cytoplasm, the nucleus, male sperm nucleus and a female egg nucleus will be combined to form a zygote. So after that zygote, what happened, the cleavage will be started. So it producing two identical cell called a blastomeres. So it start to fertilization happen in this picture. You see the fertilization will be happen. So automatically the two cells are formed, the division will, two nucleus are combined to form a zygote. So first two cells are, they are the first cleavage is happen, two identical cells are called as a blastomere. These producing four cell stages, then it is a eight cell stage. After 4 cell stage, 8 cell stage, after 72 hours, fertilization loosen, collection of a cells form a barrier shaped cluster. It is 16 or more than cells are called as a morula. So here seeing the morula are formed after 72 hours. So it start to divide to form a clupsy of cells. It is called as a morula. So under influence of progestation, smooth muscles of fallopian tubes divided to embryo take 4 to 5 days. So next, these 4 to 5 days after, it's a start to this uterine wall will be formed. At the point of embryo, that fluid filled hollow ball of above 100 cells is called as a blastocyst. See, you see this picture, how the blastocyst is formed. So the cells are divided to form a hollow fluid filled cell structure. It is called as a blastocyst. The blastocyst is composed of a single layer of large flattened cell. It is called as a tropoblast. It's a small cluster of 20 to 30 round cells in the inner cell mass. The inner cell mass of blastocyst developed an embryo and become embedded in the endometrium wall. You see this picture, the morula is entering in the uterus, then uterus wall will be thickened. So early blastocyst, then blastocyst is formed. So this blastocyst will be attached to the uterine wall. This condition, it is called as a embryo. So and become embedded endometrium of the uterine. This process is called as a implantation and its result in pregnancy. Implantation, fertilization is taken in a fallopian tube and implantation is taken place in a uterine. So blastocyst, tropoblast happen, then embryo is formed, then the embryonical structure will be formed, then that will be implemented in the endometrium wall. So now the pregnancy will be started. If the fertilized ovum is implanted outside the uterus, result in ectopic pregnancy. So when the uterus wall implementation is not happen in a uterus, it happen outside, that means vagina or outside that region, it is called as a ectopregnancy. About 95% of ectopregnancy occur in the fallopian tube. In this region itself, blastocyst will be attached to form an embryo. The growth of the embryo may cause internal bleeding, infection, and in some cases even the death due to rupture of fallopian tube. So when it started to grow, it's not a space, enough space to grow a embryo. So that will be enlarge that fallopian tube, and also it will be ruptured. So it causes a death to that person, ectopic pregnancy person. So this is how the fertilization and implementation takes place in a female reproductive organ. So this lesson will be stopped here. So in this lesson, what are the structure, male and female reproductive structure we are seeing, male producing a sperm and female producing a ovum. So then in a female, the another one primary thing will be seen, it is a mammary gland we have seen. Then gametogenesis, spermatogenesis and oogenesis we are seen here. So in the spermatogenesis, the sperm will be produced, millions of sperm will be produced. In oogenesis, only one ovum or egg will be produced. The structure of ovum we are seen here. Then what is menstrual cycle, what is a menstrual disorder all happen, then how we keep our menstrual time, hygienic condition in our body, what is menopause we are seen, then when fertilization and implementation are also seen in this lesson. Thank you students, we finished the chapter 2, human reproduction. Thank you, my dear.